Hello everyone, welcome back to ETS2. Let me go ahead and fix the map. That's the first thing I messed up. So we got 202
Let me get
miles
the
to go.
job done.
Still using the same truck over here. So let's get on the road. One thing everyone's been watching the videos over here. Why there's some ETS too? I don't play it as much as I do ATS, and I know that. We'll turn that map off in just a minute.
Oh, get ready to turn left. Turn left.
Hope everyone's doing well. Not really a lot of news going on for ETS2, and they are still working on the Heart of Russia. Do not have a release date for that exactly yet, for that being said. They haven't said anything about any more DLC this year, right now, for ETS2. So we'll see what we get. Dealership. Look real quick, see if we got to get on the ferry. I'm not sure. Let's see here. No, straight run, which is good. Sometimes it's good to have a straight run like that. You don't always want to get on the train or on the ferry. You just want to do a straight run sometimes. So good to see that. I hit the wrong button. Still a beautiful game. Put our cruise control on. We're going to get a thumbnail. using the MAN. Over just a little bit here. About right there. Setting out to do another real company run in ATS. Over in this lane. We have 147 miles and 45 miles to go. It's been a little bit, guys. We got in actually done a run over here, so I want to get in here and do a run over here. As you all know, I don't use too many modded trucks. Occasionally, I will use one. Mostly, what I use is SCS trucks. That's what I prefer to use. Nothing wrong with modded trucks. They're awesome. They're great. The modders do a fantastic job. But for me, I prefer to use a modded STS truck. And the biggest issue with that is because these games are updated so much that you go and you spend $200,000 on a truck and it updates tomorrow and the truck's not working. Then you just spend $200,000 and it doesn't work. And you know how long it takes you to make $200,000 in this game to buy one truck? That cheats a long time, so that's kind of why I've got a point where I just don't use modded trucks much. lot in this video. You sick guys. Okay. Sorry about that. Setting up, I believe, after this, we're gonna do some heavy hauls over here. Haven't done none in a while, so we're gonna get us a heavy haul truck, and I may already have one in the garage. I'll look and see. Just change it up a little bit, you know, just do something a little bit different. Hit the wrong button. We would hit the wrong button. I'm being quiet, looking at the sights here. We're driving. Can't turn right on red in over there in Europe. You have to wait for the green. Like a little MG, maybe a Jaguar though. Yeah, I believe it is a Jaguar, but yeah, it looks more like a Jaguar now that I'm thinking about it. Get over here. Big old building. Big old building up there in front of us, sir.
Ready to turn.
All right, well, they want it. Using Johnny Cash's sounds, his engine's interior sounds, brake sounds, all that, and it works on the ETS 2 and ATS. Get it lined up here. Let me take a look. Get out and take a look here. Yeah, now we can get, if we can start turning it sharp. These trucks turn a lot easier than American trucks do, so. Straightened up just a little bit here. All right, we drove excellent. We drove 202 miles. Took us 5 hours and 44 minutes to get here. Consumed 100.5 gallons of fuel. Alright guys, that's going to be it for the video. I want to get into an ETS 2 run. Like I said, we're going to switch up a little bit, I think. Do some heavy hauls over here for a little bit. So I want to say thank you for watching. Thank you everyone that's been subscribing. And have a good day.